Hey guys, today I'm going to be continuing on my beginner's guide series, this time with Ana. Ana is a challenging support, she's got great heals, she has very powerful power spikes. What I mean by a power spike is essentially at a certain level or at a certain quest complete, she gains such a high amount of power that she turns into a hero much stronger than she was before. And she's great at enabling mages with a powerful boost that she gains at level 10. Her current meta build is called her Piercing build, which is based off of her Piercing Dart ability that when you finish the quest, it makes it to where both your Sleep Dart and your Healing Dart will pierce through one target at an increased range. You also get a couple other neat perks about when you sleep someone, you're applying doses and lowering their spell damage, and level 13 is kind of a toss-up based off of the enemy composition. Following up the rest of the build is just increasing in healing. Now, I use common maps for the majority of the heroes that I'm doing this, but Ana is not really map-based. She's more based off of the team compositions, and her common maps tend to work around the same teams that she would normally be playing with. For example, her most common map is Tomb of the Spider Queen because she works well with mages, and mages work well on that map because you're going to be likely rotating. Same thing with Braxis. Mages thrive on this map because it's very poke heavy and she works well with mages. So the maps that she's going to be played on might have some similarities to those of mages that she will be playing with. What I recommend for you to do is head into try mode and start practicing a few of her abilities. One of the major ones is kind of see how reasonably, how difficult it is to take the Sleep Dart quest at one and complete this quest. You can see the long cooldown that it has and how difficult it is to land because it's such a slow moving projectile. But the only reason why I would say it might not be the best to go into try mode to practice is because if you look in the top left, you probably can't read it because it's very, very small. I have this thing that says what server I'm on. And what that means is if you're going to be playing on in Hero League, you might be, say you're in North America, there's a chance you're going to be on two different servers, Western and Central. And on both of those servers, you're going to have a different amount of ping. Ping means the amount of milliseconds it takes for you to press a button and for that your character to react to that button. Usually it's anywhere between, I would say, 10 and 150 milliseconds. So normally it's not that big of a deal, but when you're playing a hero like Ana, those couple milliseconds could be the difference between landing a dart and missing a dart. So you definitely want to practice with a little bit of ping, which is why I don't actually recommend you guys practice in try mode. I recommend taking Ana straight into versus AI because the most important things for her is practicing landing her heals over and over and over. So I would immediately take her into versus AI, and it's okay however whatever difficulty you want to do, but we're simply just going to go to Ana. And we will be taking her into AI. The things I recommend practicing on Ana when you do get into an AI game is pretty much landing her heals, finishing her E quest as fast as possible, as that is her biggest power spike imaginable. And then finally, the last thing that I would recommend doing is attacking, getting your damage over time on enemies while moving around. So we'll actually step back into try mode for just a little bit because I don't want to have to load into an actual game. It's a lot easier to just load into try mode. But I'll show you guys what I'm talking about with the auto attack and moving. So essentially what I mean is when we see this Arthas in here, you never want him to be able to actually get in range of you. So you want to be able to attack him and back up and attack him and back up and attack him and back up. And this process is called stutter stepping to be able to move and attack. And you can see how I have a lot of damage over time on this Arthas right now. So you can see this little damage over time that's just hitting him with all five of these things on there. This also heals me. Say I'm in range of this Arthas and I'm taking damage, I'm also getting healed from this damage over time that I'm doing because of this thing called Shrike. So that is something that you really want to practice on Ana. So overall, you want to practice landing your Qs and your Es in try mode. Sorry, in versus AI. Because that's actually going to put you on either Central or Western. But in this mode, it's okay to practice the attack move so that you can gain self-healing. As you can see, it's not a bad rate of healing if you really wanted to attack and move and attack and move and attack and move. You can actually heal yourself a decent amount. That's essentially the main things that I'd recommend practicing on Ana before you get into a real game, and understand that her ultimate ability, Nano Boost, is very powerful on mages. It lasts for 8 seconds, giving them cooldown reduction, mana, and extra spell damage. So if you did want to throw that onto someone really quick, I usually recommend it right as the fight starts, right when they first start casting their first ability, because the way that spell damage works now is it activates as soon as you get the spell damage, not as soon as the cast was made. So if someone starts casting ability and you nano boost them, they're gonna still get that bonus damage. So that's usually when I recommend the first initial point of the nano boost, so they get the most value out of the spell damage and the most value out of the cooldown reduction. Hopefully this helped you guys out if you were interested in playing Ana, and feel free to check out some of my other videos. Thank you.